Passage read today from Esther talks about the time when the Jews had been sentenced to death in the later part of the year. A little background. Queen Esther was chosen by King Xerxes to become his wife. She kept her lineage hidden from him. She was a Jew. At that time, before that, her cousin, Mordecai, her parents had died, so he had promised to take her in and show her good care. So when King Xerxes selected her to be his queen, Mordecai kept in communication with Esther to kind of convey on what was going on in the world around them. What had happened was that Mordecai was standing outside of the palace gates, and King Xerxes had just selected a new palace leader, and that was Haman. Mordecai refused to bow down to Haman. He refused to worship him and give the same respect as he would to the king. Haman became so enraged that not only did he plot to kill Mordecai, but he found out the religion and culture that Mordecai was, which was Jewish, and then plotted to destroy all the Jews. With Haman's position in the kingdom, he was able to convince Xerxes to destroy all the Jews, a devastating blow. And that decree had just been sent out throughout the land that they would be killed in the last month of the year. So what did the queen do? Well, at first she was scared. Whenever we are presented with a troubling conflict, we often worry about what the outcome will be for us and for those closest to us. It's hard always to see the bigger picture, to see those around us. Queen Esther was scared because she was Jewish. According to the decree, she would have to be killed as well. So in the passage that we read, we were reminded, particularly Esther is reminded, that through all God, all things are possible. Mordecai says to Esther, "You cannot hide within the palace, just as we cannot hide from the things that ail us." He said to her, "You must go and confront the king and tell her what is going to happen is a wrong in the eyes of God and in the eyes of the world." And Esther reminded Mordecai that if she was not summoned and she went into the king's room, she would be put to death. Mordecai said to her, "Well, you must try. If you don't try, God will bring out the Jews in some way, but surely you will die. If you do try, through the glory of God, you may be saved." Esther understood what she was set to do then. Thanks to God and his plan, Esther was put into that position as queen. Later on in the book, she went before the king and told her what was going on. The king realized the evil plan that had been made, and he ordered that Haman be put to death. Esther was scared. She was scared to do what was right because she knew it was going to be hard and that she could lose her life. How How often are we presented with a challenge today where the result may not be death, but it could be the loss of friends, money, time, time spent with loved ones? God knows that we are here, and we know that our purpose is to serve Him. God has put all of us into a position that is best suited to work out His plan. When we become scared, just as Esther was, we need only be reminded that God is forever with us. God is not going to turn our backs or turn His back on us. He loves us too much. We may be scared, but in God we need not have fear. So as you go out into the world, remember what Esther learned. In God, there is salvation. In God, there is peace. There is hope. And most of all, there is love. We need not fear with God. He is our rock and our salvation. And no matter what ailments may befall us, no matter what trials and tribulations we must undergo, God walks by us step by step, and He is with us now and forever. And it is because of that that we are able to gather here today. It is because of that that we are able and encouraged to go out into the world and spread His good news. Spread the news of the sacrifice that the Son made for us, so that someday we may join God in everlasting life. You need not fear. In God, all things are possible. And with that, all God's children said, Amen.